Tunisia. Live.
Be informed.
Be involved.
When wandering the streets of Djerba souk, you might be surprised to find Hebrew inscriptions adorning the walls of jewelry stores in a Muslim country like Tunisia. In fact, Tunisia is not just a country of Muslims, it is also home to nearly 1,000 Jews. Djerba is called the Island of Dreams for a reason, because of its fabulous beaches, the sparkling sun, and the surprising cohabitation between the Jews and Muslims of Djerba. Steps into the Jewish section of the island, the cultural differences will capture your attention, and this unique area plays a large part in the touristic beauty of the region. Bukhris Avi is a young Jew who lives in the Jewish section in Djerba. The young man described to us his life living side by side with Muslims.
Life is the same for us. We have been living with Muslims since a long time ago, and nothing has changed in recent years.
Djerba Synagogue, meaning the strange when translated into English, is another tourist attraction on the island of Djerba due to its mystical history and the huge annual celebration of Lag Bomer held within its walls. This vast synagogue is both a prayer house and open for tourists. Tourists who pay Djerba a visit will discover a significant part of the Jewish culture lying in the Arab country of Tunisia. According to Bukhris, Jews on the island of Djerba are not particularly connected to Tunisian politics. Rather, they most prefer to live their lives and to practice their religion.
We have nothing to do with politics. We practice our religion and we live a quiet life here.
Perhaps it is the non-involvement of the Djerbian Jews in politics that is behind the harmony between the two ethnicities on the island. In any case, their peaceful coexistence makes Tunisia a model to be followed in this respect.
Available on tunisialive.net.